/ Me Too hysteria, mall Santas now under attack by woman they didn't harass. Feminist rails against mall Santas. In one very odd story on the website Scary Mommy, a writer named Angela Chang claims that making her little girl sit on Santa's lap during the holiday season is promoting rape culture. Seriously. That's how far the / Me Too campaign created to raise awareness of pervasive sexual misconduct in Western society has fallen in approximately 6 weeks. Take a look at the following excerpt in which, well, she thinks she is making a point. This author was very, very emotional about what she had to say. A better way to say that in this context is simple: Chang is hysterical, and so fixated on victimization that everything around her looks like the launching point for a crusade. Combining the concepts of sexual misconduct and Santa Claus is something I'd expect to see in a little read, private Facebook rant, not in a publication, even one with an inane name, and apparently inane readership, like Scary Mommy. A child's interaction with Santa Claus is not contributing to rape culture. Honestly, I can't believe I just had to form that sentence. Chang is just writing in an emotionally stunted, crowd-riling manner. I'll show you what I mean with another completely innocuous example, written as manipulatively as possible. Now, I just made that up. But in terms of tone, it's pretty close to the passage written by Chang, and again, completely innocuous. When someone, anyone, is fixated on a given person, concept, or thing, everything around them starts to either look like it can relate to it, fit into it, or be applied to it. Awareness of sexual misconduct and stopping the victimization of the vulnerable should always be championed, but this is moving into lunacy. The / Me Too hashtag campaign to promote awareness of sexual harassment and crimes against women got its start on October 15, when actress and Harvey Weinstein accuser Alyssa Milano kicked it off with a Twitter post that drew attention around the world, as the New York Times reported approvingly. By the end of November, it's become a vehicle for real and imagined victimization that's now smearing shopping mall Santas who've done nothing more than play a role Western society has honored and enjoyed for generations. Every one of them could be as pure as the driven snow, for all writers like Angela Chang know.